Hey, Mr. Hendrickson.
Absolutely, I'm Mr. Hendrickson. Hi. Hi, you can call me Adam. Yeah, sorry I kept you waiting and stuff, dude. You wouldn't believe the night I had.
Tell me about it.
All right. I will. Yo, check it. So we started up the night at the 7-Eleven, getting some slurpees with my friends, Bishop Devin. We paid for it cash, no credit, no sass, but outside there was a full Armageddon. We walked out the door and we met at first by a fucking Viking. I'm gonna call him Lurch, and not a crossbow he had with him at his side. Then he shot at us, and both my friends then died, and I dodged it all, cause to his surprise, I went head first into my training. Which was really awesome and totally profound metaphysical shit that I learned in town. Then you added me with his battle axe, but I had my baseball bat for that. I like to keep it in my coat for this kind of situation. And I hit it so hard that it exploded. Celebrity thought saying I too doubted. And the Viking swore he'd see my entire stroom. So I jump kicked him right in the chest, and my buddies had lived and made a test. He went flying right into the dumpster. So I went on up and set it all on fire. He picked it up and I threw it to the moon. Shit, man. That's when I got hit in the neck by this freaking tranquilizer dart, and I just went down. When I came to, I was in an old warehouse. I was tied up to a chair like some fucked up mouse. I saw the ninjas, they were down on one knee, swearing to a man their true fealty. I promise it's true, man, there's no doubt, but the leader was a man that I won't leave out as Ozzy Osbourne. So terrifying! This is about the time that the shit got real, and I flexed through my ropes, I got muscles like steel. The ninjas came running with their swords unsheathed, then I broke them in a second with a sharp bike leaf. The ninjas got scared and they turned into logs. Didn't say a word, but I know dialogue. I had to sense their auras, started like the noise that I made them all pay like metal mixed in dogs. What? Don't know?
Driver I had before. into his car and he started driving. The drive, it took forever. Now I've never been too familiar with the roadways of Vancouver, but I can read street signs like Jeff. It's always been a skill of mine. Then we got to Maple Ridge and pulled into a small 7-Eleven. Got out of the car. That's when things went and got a little weird for me, because waiting in the parking lot were who appeared to be Ozzy Osbourne, Little Ninja, and some Vikings. I couldn't hear what they were saying. But then Adam went and got jumped. The ninjas and the Viking held him back while Ozzy went to town. He punched him in the neck and the throat and the ribs and the solar plexus. Adam was in rough shape after that.
Chin, Adam, are you okay?
I don't know, man. I'm pretty beat up.
I know. I'm calling 911. Yeah, hi. I'm calling from the 7-Eleven on 248th Street with a male aged 30-ish, suffering from a severely broken arm and clavicle. From the looks of the bruising, likely broken ribs, and internal bleeding. Please, send an ambulance, quickly. No, I'm a nurse. I just happen to be here. Yeah, of course I'll stay. Thank you.
Hey, Mac?
Yeah, Adam, look, try not to talk, man. The ambulance is on its way.
I think that I might be out of the game a little while. Don't worry about it, cause I'll heal with some style. The problem that I'm seeing is I don't think I can help you now. Meet up with my mother now, it's looking pretty doubtful now.
I understand where you're coming from. You're kind of my only hope on this. Is there anything you'll do?
That's what you're thinking, man. I'm saying that you're wrong. Just open up your ears while I sing my final song. Go and find my sister. Just tell her that I missed her. She can hook you up if you play some music like a trickster.
If I play music for her? Why?
Cause she's eccentric and she'll want you to work. And there's a spectrum along the hectic words. If you make a request so nice, she's gonna help you out. She won't charge a price, there is no doubt. Well, you might actually need to buy a coffee or something while you're there. I'm not really sure what the rules are.
What do you mean?
Well, this sister of mine, she has an open mic. It's off in Toronto and I hear it's pretty tight. If you wanna go, just say the word. I'll fly you down there and you'll have preferred seated on your plane there.
Thanks, Adam. You've definitely given me some stuff to think about. Hey, the ambulance is here. Look, I'm coming with you to the hospital. You're gonna be fine. Don't worry.
The two EMTs in that ambulance were great. They agreed with my original assessment about the broken ribs. They proceeded to clean and bandage the wounds, as well as brace the body up. Oh, so nicely. Suddenly he sneezed. Achoo! Achoo! And then he coughed some blood and had some trouble breathing. Thankfully, that was about the time we arrived at the hospital and he was rushed inside. He was being worked on within 10 minutes, and I got to watch it all from the observation deck. All in all, he had 4 broken ribs. His collarbone and his left arm were were shattered. He also had a black eye. And he had fallen into a coma. But he's stable now. Don't worry about it. He'll be fine, I guess. When I left the hospital, I was met for a third and final time by the same chauffeur from before. I got into his car and he drove me off to the airport. And when we got there, he gave me an envelope which contained a ticket to Toronto and a prepaid stay at a Best Western hotel. Oh boy. The ticket was a one-way one, but it was first class. Should I go? I guess, why not? I've already come this far. What else could happen? I don't really know.